In this lecture, we will learn about using insert into SQL statement. The insert into SQL statement is used to insert or add new data rows in a table. There are two methods to insert the data rows in a table. In first method, column names are not specified and the values are given in a bracket separated by a comma. In this method, the values for each column must be specified and the values should be provided sequentially by columns. In second method, the column names are given in first bracket and the values are given in another bracket. In this method, we can insert values to only selected column names. This is the convenient way to store the data rows, as we can see which value is going to be stored in which column. While using insert into statement, the string values must be wrapped in single quotes, while wrapping numeric values in quotes is optional or not required. Here are some examples showing use of insert into SQL statements. Let's learn more about using insert into SQL statements with some practical examples. Here I have logged in my MySQL database server using my root username and password. I'll select the school database and run a simple SQL statement to display all the data rows in teachers table using SQL statement select star from teachers. Currently we have only 5 data rows in our teachers table. Let's add a new data row using insert into statement. The SQL statement will be insert into teachers values in the brackets value null comma teacher name Peter Brown comma and the phone number. Complete the bracket, use semicolon to terminate the SQL statement. In this insert into SQL statement, column names are not specified. Since the teacher ID column is auto increment, that is, it will automatically add the next number of the data row, we provided the null value, means no value for that column. I will hit enter to run the SQL statement. And if you see the message query OK, one row affected, it means the data row was successfully inserted to the table. Let's get the data row from teachers table again. I'll press up arrow key to display the previously executed SQL statement and get select star from teachers again. And you can see the new teacher data row is added successfully in the teachers table. Now let's get the data row from students table using SQL statement select star from students. This time we will specify the data columns name and values in the SQL statement. So to add a new data row in students table, the SQL statement will be insert into students in first bracket the column names first name comma last name comma class age values in another bracket name of the student surname the class and the age of the students. Complete the bracket, use semicolon to terminate the SQL statement. press enter to execute the SQL statement, and we successfully inserted the new data row in students table. This time we use column names in first brackets and the values in another brackets. Imagine if we have a table with more than 30 column names, which will make the insert statement without column names a little difficult to understand which values are going to store in which column. Also, out of many columns, probably we only want to insert the data rows in a few columns, which is not possible using first method. Using this second method is more convenient compared to previous method, as here we can see the data column names and the values.